स्वागत है आपका शॉर्ट हैंडियंस गॉट इट चैनल पर। वीडियोस अगर पसंद आ जाएं तो लाइक शेयर और सब्सक्राइब कर दीजिएगा। लेटेस्ट डिक्टेशन और जॉब नोटिफिकेशंस को पाने के लिए बेल आइकन प्रेस कर दीजिएगा ताकि आपको टाइम पे आपकी डिक्टेशंस मिल सकें। थैंक यू सो मच।
स्टार्ट। ड्यूरिंग द सेट पीरियड इन द लेटर नियरली 1000 आइडेंटिफाइड स्टूडेंट्स डिड नॉट ज्वाइन आफ्टर फर्स्ट राउंड। दे वर बीइंग मॉनिटर्ड टू फाइंड आउट वेदर दे वर टेकिंग एडमिशन एट लीस्ट इन सेकेंड राउंड। DGHS प्रपोज्ड सीवियर पेनल एक्शन अगेंस्ट दोज इंडल्जिंग इन सच एक्टिविटीज। हैविंग बीन इन्फॉर्म्ड of this menace, this court passed an order barring students who take admission in All India Quota seats from being allowed to vacate seats after second round of counseling. All vacant seats after last round of counseling were directed to be filled up from a list that is forwarded to the institutions in the ratio of 10 times to the number of vacancies to ensure that all stray vacancies are filled. The contention of the appellants is that being asked to keep seats unfilled amounts to an unreasonable restriction on their right to carry on their occupation guaranteed under Article 19 in bracket 1 in bracket G of the Constitution of India. Even assuming the object of the rule is to ensure that lesser meritorious candidates do not get admission to better colleges, the measure adopted by the government in keeping seats vacant is disproportionate. This court in state of TN versus P. Krishnamurthy and others held that a subordinate legislation can be challenged on the following grounds: A. Lack of legislative competence to make the subordinate legislation. B. Violation of fundamental rights guaranteed under the Constitution of India. C. Violation of any provision of the Constitution of India. D. Failure to conform to the statute under which it is made or exceeding the limits of authority conferred by the Enabling Act. E. Repugnancy to the laws of the land, that is, any enactment. F. Manifest arbitrariness or unreasonableness. It is relevant to examine whether a subordinate legislation can be declared as unconstitutional on the principle of proportionality. This court in Kerala State Beverages Corporation Limited versus P.P. Suresh held the challenge to the order dated 7-8-2004 by which the respondents were deprived of an opportunity of being considered for employment is on the ground of violation of Articles 14, 19 and 21 of the Constitution of India. Lord Diplock in Council of Civil Service Unions versus Minister for the Civil Service held that the interference with an administrative action could be on the grounds of illegality, irrationality and procedural impropriety. He was of the opinion that proportionality could be an additional ground of review in the future. Interference with an administrative decision by applying the Wensbury principles is restricted. I am very happy to be present here today for opening the new building of your university. All that you have said about this new university, which is only 6 years old, is commendable in many respects. Although you have not had adequate equipment and the necessary where with hell in the beginning these serious shortcomings did not discourage you. In right earnest you started the work. One might feel sorry, but I am sure no one will feel surprised to know that in its seventh year this university does not possess departments in subjects like Sanskrit and English on the side of arts and physics, chemistry, anthropology and geology on the side of science. I need not say much about the importance of the Sanskrit language, which besides having its own vast treasure house, stop over.
तो दोस्तों ये डिक्टेशन आज की हो गई है और जिस किसी को भी ऑनलाइन क्लासेस चाहिए हैं ऑडियो और पीडीएफ के साथ वो पर्सनल व्हाट्सएप मैसेज कर सकता है अबाउट सेक्शन में जाकर यूट्यूब के अबाउट सेक्शन में नंबर दिया हुआ है आप व्हाट्सएप कर सकते हो और आपकी रिक्वायरमेंट बताकर आप डिक्टेशंस और पीडीएफ ले सकते हो. थैंक यू सो मच. बाय बाय.